Hey everybody, welcome back. And in this video, we're going to talk about orthographic views. At this point, you might be asking yourself, what exactly is an orthographic view? Well, the best way to illustrate that is to show you one inside the editor here. So we have our basic project up that we've been working out of. It's just a blank project with starter content enabled. So let's show you the orthographic view. If we go into our viewport in the upper right-hand corner, we have a minimize maximize button here. And if we click that, that's going to drop us into a four view here. Primarily, we've been working inside the perspective viewport here, but now we have an additional three views, which are our orthographic views. The top one up here is our side view. Over here, we have our front view. And right here, we have our top view. Now, they're all presented in wireframe, and this is something that you would see typically in a construction blueprint. This allows you to get just a little bit more precise control over how things are placed inside your level. For example, if I select the chair here, you can see it's selected in our perspective view, but it's also selected in each of our orthographic views. Say, for example, we wanted to make sure that this chair is right on the floor, which it is. We would be able to see that more clearly inside an orthographic view and the wireframe. And that actually leads us to talk about the different methods of navigating an orthographic view, because they're a little bit different than our perspective view here. So as you can see, we're in our perspective view, and I'm using the holding the right mouse button and looking around in 3D space. Obviously, we cannot do that inside our orthographic views here. So holding the right mouse button inside an orthographic view allows us to drag and pan around our orthographic views. So we can move around inside just by right mouse button and dragging. Now, as I do this, you can see that the other views try to remain aligned to the position of the camera in our current view. That just helps us with our orientation and our level, just to make sure that we are all in the same location so that we don't get lost and disoriented. You can probably see that a little bit better here if I select a chair and I go into side view. You can see that the front and the top try to remain aligned as I move around. So that's the first method of navigating an orthographic viewport, is by right mouse button and dragging. The second method is by using the mouse wheel to zoom in and out on our graph here. So the thing about zooming in and out in an orthographic viewport is that wherever your mouse is, that will be the location in which you will zoom in. So for example, if you wanted to zoom in on this table here, we would move our mouse over it and then mouse wheel up to zoom in. And then we can mouse wheel down to zoom out. Again, if we wanted to look at this corner of our floor over here, we can mouse wheel up and mouse wheel out to zoom back out. We have one more method of navigating our viewports here. It's more of a selection, actually. If we use the left mouse button, I can talk sometimes, ladies and gentlemen. If we use the left mouse button and drag, you can see we get a little bit of a marquee selection box here. So that allows us to select things in our level just by left clicking and dragging around objects. So that's the methods of navigating the orthographic viewport. There are a couple things that we can do for the orthographic viewports themselves. Currently, we are set to wireframe on each of our viewports here. We can change this by selecting the wireframe drop box and changing the view mode. Now, we're not going to talk about all the different types of view modes in this video. We're going to talk about that in another video. But for example, we could change this to unlit, for example. And now we have an unlit view in orthographic mode of our viewport here. We can go ahead and let's actually jump back to our perspective view here. There's one other thing that I wanted to mention. So we have a full view of our perspective mode here. Say we wanted to work primarily in an orthographic view, we could click the minimize maximize button and then click one of our orthographic views and maximize it. But we could also go to the upper left hand corner and change the current view mode or current view that we are working out of by clicking this little option here. And you can see we can change back to perspective, we can change to any of the orthographic views from right here, maintaining our full view here for our viewport. And you can do that by using the dropdown or any of the hotkeys, as you see here as well. And that's basically it for orthographic views. Primarily, you're going to be doing most of your work inside the perspective viewport, which is what we have here. But again, if you are doing any kind of architectural work or building any kind of rooms or buildings where you need things to be properly aligned, you could go into an orthographic view, any of the different orthographic views, just to see how things are lining up. And then switching back to a perspective view when you are polishing it and adding additional elements to your level. But that's basically how you would go about building your levels inside the perspective and orthographic views. Hope you guys learned something, and we hope to see you guys in the next video.